How's it going, guys? Alex here. Welcome back to another Dokkan Battle video. And before I do get into it, I want to quickly apologize for that World Tournament video. I completely forgot about Xenotrunks, so if you watched it, I know a lot of people commented saying I forgot about him, so I do apologize. It just completely slipped my head. And yeah, basically, if you want to watch that video now, keep in mind I forgot about Xenotrunks, and that Xenotrunks is obviously better than Chowman. I'll probably redo that video at a future date. So, I'm feeling a bit better now, and hopefully I can just smash this video out for you guys and give an informative video. So, today we are going to be taking a look at the physical Kaioken Goku. Not too long ago, the AGL type obviously got a rebirth himself, and one of the comments in my last SSR Analysis video mentioned to just compare them, the undoken version and the doken version slightly, just so you see what the major changes were. And obviously the leader skill for the most part does stay the same. The only difference is that he gets a defensive boost. He gives a defensive boost and key, obviously, so that's interesting. I didn't actually realize that he gave key and a stat boost to three types. And unfortunately it's still not physical and STR, but maybe in the future. So greatly raises attack, that stays the same. Now this is a big step up. The same happened with the AGL Kaioken Goku. Huge damage to supreme damage, so that is definitely a big step up. Changes STR orbs to rainbow orbs, and he gets a 40% attack boost. I've said this before numerous times, percentage boosts are much better than flat out boosts, and he gets a 40% boost. That is actually not too bad. Like before, he fit pretty well on a monophysical team anyway, despite not hitting hard, just because of his utility. He provides orbs for units like Goku Black, and he obviously bridges gaps between units like Full Power Frieza and, you know, Ultimate Gohan, if you decide to use Ultimate Gohan, because Shocking Speed is a more prevalent link. I'm pretty sure that's the right word, a more prevalent link on monophysical now, if you run a certain setup. So he's a pretty decent unit, despite not hitting that hard. But if I'm not mistaken, the flat-out boost that Kaioken, the AGL Kaioken Goku gets is equivalent to like 30%, maybe a little bit less, whereas the Goku obviously gets a 40%, and if you get dupes, that is definitely going to increase the amount that that obviously increases the amount that he is going to hit for. And if you have a look down here, his 12 key multiplier goes from 120, if you have a look down here, which is pretty damn bad, to 130. I've said this before, 130 is pretty bad, but it really doesn't matter because he wouldn't hit that hard anyway. So he gets a 30% super attack boost, and the super attack boost obviously stacks. So I've said this before, but because of the way that the Dokkan events currently are, that boost obviously resets for every stage. So basically, say you are taking on the Super Assembly Kaioken event, and you're on the first tech stage, and you boost his attack by a reasonable amount, if you move on to the next stage, that would reset. That is why the Kaioken mechanic isn't as good as it was previously. And it's a shame, because they have a lot of damage potential. They could obviously be the hardest hitters in the game if the face switches didn't affect the Kaioken mechanic. But obviously, if it didn't affect the Kaioken mechanic, I would see it being slightly OP, because obviously, if your team isn't that great and you take your time with specific events, then their attack, well, his attack damage, for example, could reach 1 million damage easily. I know that's nothing for like units like Super Saiyan 4 Goku and, you know, Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta on some occasions, but you get the point. So his links, all in family, the Saiyan lineage, Kamehameha, Shocking Speed, and Overn Flash, and Shattering the Limit. So again, Shattering the Limit is obviously the rebirth link. Not too common on his mono team, of course, but if you ever decide to run several units with that link, I guess it fits well. But his main links are obviously Shocking Speed and Overn Flash, which I mentioned earlier, allows you to bridge gaps between certain units. And even if he doesn't link too well with some of the units on your team, he still changes orbs, which makes up for that, which is nice. And again, that leader skill, I kind of hoped it was different, but hopefully I can pull him, because if I'm not mistaken, in this world tournament, if you get, you can get nine guaranteed SSR tickets. So that's a big chance of pulling him, and I hope I do, so I can do some videos with him as a lead. But now let's move on to the team building portion of this video, of course. And we are going to be running, well, we're going to be demonstrating what a monophysical team would look like, and then moving on to a hero team. And there's Xenotrunks. Well, that's pre-doken, so my bad. Please do forgive me for that, don't butcher me. So grab these units, grab the Trunks as well, might as well. I really like support units. I know a lot of people would prefer to have a unit that hits harder than a unit that just supports, but I personally like support units. So who are we missing? Vegeta or Blue, Goku Black over, you know what, let's go ahead and grab Full Power Freezer. Actually, you know what, I'm going to grab Gotenks because I really like him, and ceiling, I'd say, is kind, I'd say is pretty important on a mono-physical team, because, again, not that many defensive units. You have Vegeta Blue, who can tank to an extent, but can nowhere near tank as much as Super Vegito. Of course, if he gets super attacked, he gets absolutely demolished, so it's nice to have a sealer, just to keep those super attacks at bay. So let's go over the team. Of course, we have Kaioken Goku, who doesn't link too well with the majority of the units here. He does share over in the flash with Vegito Blue, but again, as I stated before, his orb-changing abilities make up for that. Basically, every single unit here links really well anyway. Of course, you have Fuse Fighter and Prepare for Battle here. You have Prepare for Battle. All of these units have Prepare for Battle apart from Kaioken Goku. Like, this combination here is so damn good because of, obviously, the orb-changing abilities. It's like Android 13 on a... mono int team. Alternatively, if you didn't have Kaioken Goku, you could run SS Blue Vegeta, but I personally do prefer Kaioken Goku. I just think he's a better orb changer. So, oh, pardon me. And let's now go ahead and make a hero team. So, it's actually crazy how, it's understandable, but Super Saiyan 4 Goku and Vegeta just instantly jump into a hero team, and it makes sense. They are extremely good units and top 5 in the game, which reminds me, in the coming days or weeks, I'm not too sure, I should hopefully be able to make a video on the top 5 units with D3 and Zenroth. So Super Vegito, it didn't take me that long to find him there. Okay, so let's go ahead and grab Trunks. So Goku and Trunks are definitely going to have a good partnership. Again, not too many links in this team. He does have shocking speed with... So I went ahead and grabbed the Trunks, but the problem with this is that Kaioken Goku does change STR orbs into INT orbs. So I think it depends on which one activates first, but if he, if Kaioken's passive does activate first, he's basically taking all of Trunks's STR orbs to change to INT, because if you didn't know, Trunks changes STR orbs into INT-type orbs, so if Goku changes them first, then he is obviously missing out on orbs, and that could definitely be a bit of a problem. You will most likely have to keep the two separate, but he does share a lot of links with his team, actually, apart from Trunks, of course. He has shocking speed with Super Saiyan 4, he has shocking speed with Super Vegito, he has over in a flash with Vegito Blue, and he has shocking speed with Super Saiyan 4 Goku. So he links much better on this team than he does on a mono-physical team. Obviously, it depends on the units that you do run. You could potentially mess up Trunks on a few occasions, which is a shame, but apart from that, I don't think Kaioken Goku works too well on a hero team, just simply because there aren't too many units that rely on orbs, apart from Trunks, of course. But the thing about Trunks is that his attack has to be boosted by in-type orbs, whereas obviously Goku changes them to rainbow, so it doesn't really work. It's not that great of a partnership. Alternatively, you could probably just run a unit like Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken or SS Blue Vegeta. If you're worried about losing out on the orbs for Super Saiyan Rage Trunks, but I think I've pretty much covered everything. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Again, I apologize for the apologize for forgetting about Xeno Trunks in my World Tournament video, but I hope you guys enjoyed this regardless. Hopefully in the coming days, I will be able to get back on the grind and not sound like I'm just dying. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I will see you all in the next one.